In this video, I want to condense as much information as humanly possible on how to perform AI art generation using just an iPhone or an iPad or your Mac, and I want to cover everything from beginner to very advanced topics and make it hopefully human understandable. We're going to be doing this using an entirely free-to-use application called DrawThings. The first step is to open up the App Store and download DrawThings. This application is 100% free and does not have any in-app purchases. It is available for the iPhone, iPad, and even the Mac. Using any of these devices, you can follow this tutorial. AI art generation is pre-CPU and GPU intensive, so anyone using older devices, this may or may not work. If you are one of the people who actually watched my previous video on AI, I'm going to cover a lot of the same stuff, but there is some new things. I'll interrupt myself, skip to the 13-minute mark. I will be using an iPad Pro with an M2 processor. Pretty much everything you'll see me do, you can replicate on your iPhone, as this application is fully functional on an iPhone. The user interface on the iPhone will look a little different because of the constraints of having a smaller screen. The macOS version looks almost identical to the iPad version. It of course has the advantages of a proper file system, so you can import files easier, and there's a lot more screen space. This video makes use of chapters, so you can re-reference parts or skip around. Running AI programs is a good way to drain your battery. AOHi, I hope I said their brand right, sent me over one of their GaN chargers. They're not paying me for anything, they just gave me this unit for free and asked if I liked it, would I please feature it in one of my videos. So here we are. I haven't had a video where it made more sense to mention this. I like it because it's smaller than my other 140 watt GaN charger. There's a link in the description if you're curious, and I don't get any money or commission either. When you first launch the application, you will need to download what is known as a model. If you click on the model, you'll see quite a few models available, but what we want is to start with SDXL Refiner. While this downloads, let's talk about what we're downloading because this is really important, and I don't want to bog down this video with a bunch of boring explanations, but this is really important stuff. DrawThings is a front end or a graphical user interface for Stable Diffusion. A model in machine learning such as Stable Diffusion is a trained neural network that has learned to generate images by analyzing extensive sets of images and text. To translate this back into human speak, each model uses different source images and text. Some people create different models based on art styles or content. Some of them are really good at people, some are general purpose. Some are really good at mimicking different styles of illustrations, and some are photorealistic. They vary also quite a bit in quality. SDXL Refiner is by Stability AI, the people who created Stable Diffusion, and it's very general purpose and generally pretty high quality. Okay, we are now done with the boring lecture part. I hope you have a vague idea of what models are, because we're going to be doing some really cool stuff with them later. Also, you do not need an active internet connection once you've downloaded the models. Back to Stable Diffusion. Right now, the interface looks kind of confusing, but we can see that there's a default prompt, the text on the screen. The prompt is the thing we'd like to see. Right now, the default prompt says, a samurai walking towards a mountain, 4K, highly detailed, sharp focus, grayscale. Let's just click generate and see what we get. This will take some time, so I'm going to fast forward to the end result. That's actually a pretty amazing image, honestly. We could continue to use this same prompt and generate more images that would be similar in nature. If we were to change the prompt, it would change the content of the images that it's rendering. To reiterate that, if you type something in and hit generate, it'll spit out an image. That's pretty simple, so let's do something a lot more advanced. Since we are just talking about models, let's download a different one. This is done by tapping the model name to bring up the menu. I'm going to scroll down and download Realistic Vision version 3. Realistic Vision focuses on rendering images of humans. Let's skip ahead and it's downloaded. Now let's generate an image with our same prompt. Again, we got another pretty good image. Now let's try adding a negative prompt. Prompts are the results you want to see, and negative prompts are the results you don't want to see. Pretty easy. Let's try adding some negative prompts to this. I've given it slightly contradictory information here. I'm asking it to make a person walking towards a mountain, but not facing away from the camera. Also, let's remove grayscale. Plus, I'll refine this just a little bit more. Let's click generate, and the end result is, well, it's not as cool as the original. It's time to refine this prompt a little more. I want this guy to be closer up in the frame, so let's say photorealistic and from the waist up. Also, I'd like it to generate two images instead of one, so let's change that in the right-hand corner. Let's click generate and skip ahead in time. I have my two results, and let's say I really like this first one. If I were to click generate, it would just generate an entirely new image. So I want to refine this one, so we're going to scroll down to the left side to strength. If you notice, the moment you scroll anything below 100%, it'll switch from text to image to image to image. This means you can use an existing image along with your command prompts to generate a new image. The lower the strength percentage, the less it can deviate from the source image. We can use this to refine our results, so let's slide this down to about 70%. I think this guy could use a hat, so let's add wearing hat to the prompt. To make it easier on Stable Diffusion, I'm going to remove the word towards. Now I'll click generate, and let's view our results. Not really what I had in mind. We could try and refine this and give him a jingasa, I'm sorry if I mispronounced that, but the samurai hat. Let's tweak the prompt just a little bit more, and then we're going to change how many images we'd like to generate in the upper right-hand corner. I'm going to generate 3 this time, and of course this will take 3 times as long. This is a good demonstration of the limitations of prompts. They're not all-knowing. It seems like that realistic vision does not know what a jingasa is, so it can't generate one. Let's say we have a result we really like, but we'd like to have it higher resolution. This particular result looks pretty good, so let's use that. First, we need to scroll down and change the resolution. I'm going to render this at 768 by 768. This is where the UI of Draw Things gets a little strange. We need to scale the image manually by pinching and zooming. For Mac users, you can do this with your mouse wheel or with your trackpad. We need to make sure that the white area is completely covered. If you don't, it'll try and generate a new image in the white area. I'll revisit this concept a little bit later when we talk about inpainting. Once we have this perfectly scaled, now it's time to adjust our strength. The key here is we want this image to look a lot like the previous image, but we need to give it some leeway to fill in the details that's missing. I'm going to give it quite a bit of freedom, so I'm going to go with 50%, although you could go as low as maybe even 15 to 20% if you really want to keep it mostly the same. With Draw Things, we have another trick up our sleeve, which is AI upscaling. Let's click on the upscaler and download the real ESRGAN-X2 Plus. If you haven't yet used AI upscaling, it is not magic. After Stable Diffusion produces the image, it will then run the upscaler on said image. This will then resize the image to be twice as large. The difference between upscaling and re-rendering the image is that it cannot recreate details that aren't there. It will just simply make the image larger and keep the sharpness intact. One last thing, let's save our generated images to a folder on our iPad. This will look different on macOS, as macOS has a lot more freedom where you can save your files. Now to generate our image. On screen is the results from our image generation compared against our original image. Since I rendered more than one image, here's another one, and the details are significantly improved. Now that we've covered image to image, let's cover inpainting. Let's say we want to change just this guy's face. This is where we can use inpainting. Inpainting lets us fill in missing pieces to an image. However, you need an inpainting model. So let's download one. I hope they change this in future versions of Draw Things, but right now, the grid layout is worthless. I can't read the full file names, so let's switch to list view and search for the inpainting. This is still not perfect, but at least now we can see 1.5 versus 2.0. By the time you watch this, some of these version numbers may have changed, so just keep that in mind. Usually, the newest version is the best, so I'm going to download the 2.0 version. Draw Things has a few basic image editing options, and one of them is the erase tool. Click on it, and let's erase this guy's face. Now that I've completely erased his face, it's time to adjust the strength. I could put this at 100% and it'd probably do a reasonable job of filling in this guy's head. I am going to adjust this to 90% because I want it to look somewhat like our samurai. One last step, I'm going to adjust the text guidance. The on-screen description is a very good explanation. The higher the text guidance value, the more it will try and follow your prompt. If you want to know more about it, there's a fantastic article on getimg.ai all about Stable Diffusion's guidance scale. The link is in the description of this video. I missed one little spot, so I'm going to erase it, but if I left it in, it would have to use those pixels. The generated results are not the best, and this is because we're using entirely different models. It will try to match the model, but it can't always do a perfect job. Some models have Inpainting versions, so you can download the matching Inpainting version and have much better results. This next section, we're going to try and incorporate real-world photos that we've already taken. I have in Pixelmator on my iPad a picture of my cat Jeff, and I'm going to remove some unwanted stuff from this image. Now that I've saved it, let's import this into DrawThings. First, let's click the new page to create a new canvas. Then click the camera icon so we can import from our photo library the photo of Jeff. I'm going to speed through switching the model, typing up a description, resizing the image, and then setting the strength to 70%. Now it's time to finally talk about steps. GetImg.ai has a fantastic article explaining steps. Stable Diffusion makes images by generating noise and then refining it through cycles or steps. Each step takes a significant amount of processing time. Over time, Stable Diffusion improves the image, but there is a law of diminishing returns. This interactive graphic explains this better than I can do with words. GetImg recommends roughly 25 steps. I'm going to lower mine to 28. Let's speed through a few more last second updates, and now we're ready to generate. While it's not Jeff, it definitely took some inspiration from him. Now, I like this image, but I wish it just wasn't square. Well, we can fix that. If you notice, we zoom out that there's still the carpet background from the previous image. I could use the eraser tool, but it's just easier if I save this image and start a new canvas. So let's re-import the generated image. As we previously explored with the samurai, the Inpainting will paint in the missing pieces of the image. Let's resize the image and move back to Inpaint as our model. On second thought, I think I'm going to change the image size just a bit. I decided to off-center this image slightly so it would render more to the left of the cat. The final step is to change the strength back to 100%, which might seem counterintuitive, but watch the results. The results are actually pretty good, except for there's a line in both the images. I've zoomed in so you can really see it. Since I'm rendering all my images to my iPad, I can go into a program like Pixelmator and open up the image and start touching it up. In Pixelmator, I can use tools like the heal tool to remove the line, use the sharpen tool to give the face a little more detail, and then even go through with the warp tool and give the cat a bit of a tummy tuck since this is kind of a weird render. The end result is impressive, although the cat only has three toes. Now let's revisit models once again, but this time we're going to download models that aren't included in DrawThings off the internet. If we click the models, we can then click manage. Realistic Vision 3.0, I know for a fact, has a later version. I'm going to delete the Realistic Vision 3.0 by clicking the trash can. There are a lot of options when importing models into DrawThings, and that's unfortunately just a quirk of Stable Diffusion. I'm not going to go into all of these because it gets really complicated, but just be aware some models do require tweaking these settings. The thing we're most interested in is downloaded file. If we click it, we can enter a URL to a model. Let's cancel out of this and go to Safari. Probably the most popular host of AI models is Civitia or Civit AI. I'm not sure how it's said. From this website, we will search for Realistic Vision. This particular model is right now version 6.0 beta 1. And if you notice, it also has an Inpainting version. But for this video, we're just going to download version 6. We will do this by clicking the download icon and then copying the link. For the Mac users, you can just download this file. Now let's switch back to DrawThings. We will click enter URL and we will paste the URL. Click continue and it'll start downloading. Depending on the model, DrawThings might download supporting files. Realistic Vision's pretty good at people, so let's just do a quick one of a woman reading a book in a coffee shop at night, and it's peaceful. The results are pretty good until you look at the cursed AI hands. It's just a thing with AI still. Speaking of cursed, let me draw a not-so-good picture of my cat, Jeff, very quickly on my iPad. To my defense, I purposely wanted a bad drawing for this demo. If I go back to draw things, I can import this image. Then using one of the models I already have downloaded, I can then use this as a source image to generate a new image. After refining my prompt just a little bit and changing the strength to 80%, I got a pretty good result. There are some striking similarities here because it is mimicking the pose and it's on a flat background. iOS, macOS, and iPadOS all have the ability to lift objects out of photos. I've already imported my cat Jeff and we're using the Inpainting model. Apple's ability to lift objects out of photos is impressive, but it's not perfect. It has some weird edges. So to correct for this, I'm going to do something that might seem counterintuitive. I'm going to erase the entire image, then I'm going to scroll down and set the strength to about 25%. The Inpainting 2.0 model isn't that great, but we could always download a different one and see if we could find one that would produce better results. Maybe we could put the cat in a better sci-fi background. And probably we'd tweak the strength to be even lower. Now for our final main topic, and that's LoRAs, or Low Order Rank Adaptation. Think of these as like expansion packs for stable diffusion. LoRAs can contain quite a bit of different stuff like characters or poses or visual effects. Also, generally speaking, they are a lot smaller than models. I know of one that's really cool that works with Realistic Vision, and we already have version 6.0 downloaded. The process is pretty much exactly the same as importing a model. We are going to go back to the website Civit AI. I searched for vector illustration, and I'm going to go to that LoRA. I'm going to copy the URL, and then I'm going to go back to Draw Things and import it by clicking Manage next to the LoRA. Mac users, again, get off easy. They just click Download and then can import the downloaded file. Once it has downloaded, we will click Import. Often, LoRAs need trigger words. This one is vector illustration, but if for some reason we forgot it, we can go back to the website. If I click the info button, I can see the prompts used to generate this really sweet monster truck. Note the use of the word vector illustration. I'd like to see a vector illustration of a palm tree, so we're going to use the prompts vector illustration and palm tree. Note that I have the LoRA's weight set to 100%. When using LoRAs, you have to pay attention to the documentation. Some will recommend settings of like 60% for the best results. Some have multiple trigger words to produce different types of images. Some are designed to work really well with a certain model, like this one was trained on Realistic Vision. The end results are pretty cool. There is a lot of trial and error. I tried to generate pictures of the Oregon coast in vector art style. Some still came out as photos and some did not. There are some topics I didn't touch on, like samplers, and there's an amazing article all about the samplers and how it affects the image quality at Stable Diffusion Art. If you haven't put it together by now, a lot of those scammy apps on the Mac App Store and the iOS Store and the iPad Store that lets you generate AI images are just using Stable Diffusion. I'm debating making a full-fledged course on this, but it wouldn't fit under this channel. But I do have my Patreon, and I could also put it on Udemy or something. That way people could really dive in with me, because there are a lot of topics that I didn't cover, like control nets or even making your own LoRAs and training, because this program goes deep. If that's of interest, just let me know in the comments, and I think that's it.